Hello friends, I am Yogesh. So in last few video we had seen the assembly programming and then we moved forward, we did the timer, and timer we did in a polling mode. So yes, of course, you may be aware or may not be aware the method which we use, like what we had done is we wrote JNB, and like earlier how we wrote like this, like jump if not bit TF0 and L1, like that we wrote code earlier. So this is called the polling. Okay, so we had done programming in a polling mode. So today our topic is the interrupt. So we are going to learn today the interrupt, and even the last video we already seen the interrupt introduction, and in a general term we had seen. Today also it's a theoretical video, but we are going to see more technically and programming prospect and how basically interrupt work in this our microcontroller, that we are going to learn. This video is very, very important as far as your interview is concerned, as far as your job is concerned in the future, and moreover, like whatever future work we will be doing, we will be most of the time using the interrupt. So that from this prospect also this video is very important. So what is today's agenda is like how interrupt work in our microcontroller, what all interrupt source available in this. We are having one register, like how to configure the interrupt. For that we are having IE register, we will see about that, and the interrupt priorities also we will be seeing. And this will be like semi-technical video, and if anything is there we'll see. Okay, so if you are first time coming on this channel, I will suggest you watch from starting, then only it will make sense to you. If you are if you are watching us from beginning, then keep going and like us, share us, subscribe, comment, and help us to grow. So let's start. So in this microcontroller, I will start, give me liberty to start flexible. Actually, I will be moving from here and there, but I am sure you will be understanding. Pay attention here. We are having something called IE register. IE register is a interrupt enable register. Interrupt enable register. What this is, a 8-bit register. It is 8-bit register, and here we are having this first bit, that is like EA. This is the global enable. Global enable means if you want interrupt, make this bit 1. If you don't want interrupt, make this bit 0. So we want interrupt, we have to make it 1. What else? This is called external 0. This bit is called external 0. This is called timer 0. This is called external 1. This is called timer 1. This is called serial communication. This is not used, we will write 00. In our case, we want timer 0 interrupt. We don't want other, so we'll write it 1 here. And all other place we will write 0. So this is about the IE register. But I will explain you here about this interrupt source as well. So we are having a 5 interrupt source in our microcontroller. We are having 5 interrupt source. Out of that is 2 is the external, and other I will tell you. So external interrupt. What is external interrupt? So if we see what is external interrupt is, consider like say we are making one application. Like say this is my microcontroller, and I made put some more IC in it, and like I made it a consider like say smoke detector. So we put the smoke detector. So whenever it will detect the smoke, it will give sensing, it will give signal to microcontroller. In the previous video we had learned like interrupt is like a disturbance. So whenever it will detect the smoke, it will give signal to it. This is external signal. This is external interrupt, we can put it. Now consider what else we can put. CO2 sensor, accelerometer, gyrometer. मोशन सेंसर, टेम्परेचर, टेम्परेचर कैन गो टू एडीसी बेसिकली, सो एडीसी सेंसर मींस एडीसी गिविंग इंटरप्ट, कंप्लीशन इंटरप्ट, एंड मेनी मोर. यू कैन पुट एनी सेंसर यू वांट, लाइक मे बी से यू आर सम डाटा इज रेडी, डाटा रेडी सेंसर, एंड यू आर मे बी स्विच, सम बटन इज देयर दैट यू कैन पुट इन टू इंटरप्ट, एनीथिंग विच यू वॉन्ट इमीडिएट अटेंशन ऑन, इमीडिएट अटेंशन ऑफ माइक्रो कंट्रोलर, यू कैन पुट इट इन एक्सटर्नल, इन एक्सटर्नल सोर्स. सो वी आर हैविंग टू एक्सटर्नल सोर्स, वी आर हैविंग टू एक्सटर्नल सोर्स, वन इज एक्सटर्नल जीरो, एक्सटर्नल वन, सो लाइक दैट टू सोर्स यू कैन कनेक्ट, दैट्स ऑल, यू कैन नॉट कनेक्ट मोर देन दैट. टाइमर, सो नेक्स्ट वन इज द टाइमर. वॉट इज टाइमर? टाइमर लाइक टाइमर इज इन इनबिल्ट इन इट, टाइमर जीरो, टाइमर वन, यू नो दिस थिंग, वी हैड डिस्कस्ड दिस थिंग इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो. सो इन टाइमर जीरो, इफ यू रिमेंबर, इन टाइमर जीरो टाइम अर्लियर आई हैड डिस्कस्ड समथिंग कॉल्ड गेट पल्स. वॉट इज दैट गेट पल्स? इज द मीनिंग ऑफ गेट पल्स इज वेदर वी वॉन्ट टू स्टार्ट टाइमर, वेदर वी वॉन्ट टू स्टार्ट टाइमर ऑन द through the external or we want to start internal. It does not mean like this timer is a external, this gate is for the external, it's not like that. This gate is only telling to start timer, start the timer, start timer process. This is only for that. Okay, it is not for the telling about the like, it is not the interrupt source. Interrupt source of timer is internal. So this both timer and this are the internal timer, internal, and this external zero, they are the external. And the serial communication is mixed, that I'll discuss later. Okay, so this timers are internal, give signal internal, they will interrupt the microcontroller. And external is external, we understand this thing. So like as we had discussed just now, we are having the five interrupt source, we are having five interrupt source, and one is global enable, that required to be one. So this external zero, external zero, timer zero, external one, external one, and timer one, then serial communication, and this all are the interrupt source. Okay, so one more very important thing here we have to discuss is, then what is that very important thing? Consider like a memory. I'll make little bigger memory, reason being I want to discuss in a little detail. And this is my RAM and this is my flash. This flash memory I'll convert into 16 part so that I can clearly demonstrate what I am saying. So this will become 8 part and then it becomes 16 part. So now, okay, fine. So this is my memory, this is the memory location 00 01 02 03 04 05 06 07 08 09 0A 0B 0C 0D 0E 0F. This is my memory location. This is my 00 memory location. Okay, and if you remember in the earlier 2-3 time I discussed this thing, I'll again write it. So when we write code like move a comma something hash 05 something like that, and then like that we wrote code, after compiling and assembling this code is converted into some code like 4605 2c 4606 29 efe, like that we are writing the this is our code. And I hope you remember we had discussed in detail this thing. Even Arpit asked what is hex file, so I told this is the hex file. So when this hex file we are downloading into our microcontroller, it go and sit here. When we write it, okay, One more important thing, when we write this program, when we write program, here we are writing ORG0. What's the meaning of this ORG0? When we writing ORG0, all this source code are going and sitting from here. From here they are sitting. From here they are sitting all source code. Okay, that's how we had earlier we had discussed. But when we are using interrupt, this initial memory are having some very important role. Out of this first three byte is called reset vector. After that next 8 byte 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This 8 byte is called external 0. Next 8 byte 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This next 8 byte is called timer 0. Next 8 byte 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is called external 1. Next 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is called timer 1. Then this is called next 8 byte is called serial communication. What is this? this all are called, remember the name, they are called as vector source. They are called vector source. And this address is called, so the address is 00, 03, 0B, 13, 1B, 23. I am writing in hexadecimal. So this all number are in hexadecimal. All these are called vector address. They are all called vector address. And this table, this is called vector table. Okay, so hope you understand what I am saying. This all are vector source. They are the interrupt source or vector source, you can say. And then we are having this address. This address is called vector address. And this table is called as vector table. So hope you understand what is this memory. So earlier when we are writing program and when we say ORG0, all my source code was sitting here. Why? Because we was not using this memory for the special purpose. But now we want to use this memory for the special purpose. How to use? I am going to tell you. And currently we are only interested in this memory, timer 0 memory. Other memory also in subsequently we will be using. Now I'll tell you how to write a program. So like how we write, we say ORG0 and then we'll say jump. What we will say is ORG0, and the ORG0 means my memory is going to start from this address. And then what we had said, after that in this memory 0 location we will be writing jump somewhere. You can say like maybe start, or you can say S1 or T1, whatever you want you can say. Now if you see here carefully how many bytes I am using for this special purpose. So 8, 8, 8, 8, 5 is 40 and 43. So 43 bytes I am using for special purpose. After 43 byte I am free to write my program. So that is not a problem. So how to move my program to there? So like what I'll say? I'll say jump start, and then little down I'll say ORG maybe 50. You understand? And then here I will say start. Like that. So what is happening actually in the starting only one instruction I am writing. In the starting, only one instruction I am writing, and this instruction is going to this 3 bytes. It's going to this 3 bytes. Why? Because the after that memory having some different meaning. So what I am doing is actually on a start, I'll say jump start, and this start, that's all, it will go in a memory location at 00. And this will be, I'm writing at memory location 50. So hope it making sense. Now I can write my code. So this you already know. So you can say move, like say T mode, whatever you want. Then you can say move, TH0, move, TL0. Then IE register. So I had told you about IE register. So in IE register, what we can write in hexadecimal, this will be 8 and this will be 2. So we can write 0 cross 82. We can write 82 for the enabling the only timer 0 interrupt and global enable. If we not enable global, we will not get the interrupt. Fine. So now we have to write into IE register that we have to write 82. How to write, you know already. So you can write the move. And write move IE hash 082H, like that you can write. Fine, then you can say clear TF0 and then you can say set bit TR0. Fine. Now see your now earlier, if you remember earlier in the previous program of timer, how we was writing like this: jump if not bit TF0 L1, like that, and this is L1. So this is the loop kind of. But now we can't write this thing. This is called the polling, and we don't want to use polling now. What we want to use? We want to use the interrupt. So for interrupt, what we will say? We'll say jump L1. And L1 is here. Now you see what is the difference. I am not checking any timer flag here. Now I am free from the timer. I can do whatever I want here, but I am not checking now timer. It means I put the alarm and that's all. I am doing other activity. Now I am not checking no more. I am checking the alarm thing. What's the meaning of this? The meaning of this is now I write some value, I'll start the timer and I'll say go. Once I say go, and I'm doing my work. I'm doing whatever I want. I'm doing. Whenever this TF0 will become 1, whenever it will become 1, it will be automatically coming to this vector address. Automatically coming to this vector address that is enabled for the timer 0. It will be automatically coming to the timer 0 vector address. So it means when it come to timer 0 vector address, I need to write some source code here. I not yet wrote that source code. So how to write that source code? It's simple. We can say ORG hash 00BH. So we enable here, and then we can say jump to maybe timer 0 ISR, like that. So in this address, which is like my vector address, in that place I am saying do this activity. And in timer 0 ISR, how we are writing like this. So timer 0 ISR, you can give any name you want, and you can write your port toggling, high, TH0, TL0, whatever you want in that, after that interrupt come, you can do it here. Don't forget to write in the last return interrupt. Okay, so I'll show you like how this is going to work, so you will understand now, because our code is like some pseudo code is ready now. How it will be working? We will be starting from 0, so it will start from 0 and then it will say jump start, and then when it come to start, where we'll found start at the memory location 50. Why memory location 50? Because 8 5s are 40 and plus 3, 43 byte we need for the special purpose. That's why we are after 43 we are moving. You can move anywhere how much is memory available in controller. So you now we are moving to 50. And then we start writing our code. So we write the T mode, and then we write TH0, TL0, like that we wrote. And then we are writing the IE, interrupt enable register. So we enabled interrupt for timer 0 interrupt we had enabled. Okay. So we enabled the timer 0 interrupt. And after that we clear the flag, and then timer we started, we say go, timer is started now. Now you see here the slight change. We are not wrote here like jump if not wait TF0. We not wrote like this. This kind of code we not written here. What we said, we are doing something else. We are not doing timer related activity here. So we are doing some other activity. Now whenever timer is getting over, whenever TF is getting overflow, it will be automatically going to the corresponding vector address. It automatically going to corresponding vector address. So in corresponding vector address, we wrote the our ISR. How we wrote? We wrote like this. And in this address, means in this level, we are writing the, in this address, what in this level, whatever we are writing related to timer activity, we are writing like maybe port high, port low, TH0, TL0, that we are writing here. And don't forget to return I. So how things will work? It will start from 0, then it will come to here, it will work here, and it will come and sit here. Whenever ISR come, it will go to this address, it will go to this address. From there, it will come here. And once it got return interrupt, where it will go? To this place. Okay, so this is how we had created now interrupt. So I hope it making sense little bit and you are understanding. If it is not yet clear, don't worry. We are going to see in the next video, we are going to see the complete practical of this. And I'm sure you will be understanding there. So don't worry if you are not understanding. And that's all in this video from our side. So we had covered all this point. Interrupt priority, one point is remaining. So in this, the interrupt priority goes like this. So this is the highest priority, then less, then like that. So this is the highest priority, okay? We will be seeing this thing. So we had seen all this topic, and in the next video, we will be writing the code we already wrote, but we will make a program, and then we will execute them step by step, and I will be showing you whatever I told you. And then we will be making on and off. We will be generating the output pulse of 20 millisecond and on and off. Okay. So I'm sure you will be getting and understanding what I'm saying. So thank you for watching. Of course, like if you like it, comment it, share it. If we are making any mistake, please let us know. We will be happy to correct it. I'm just having like 20 years of experience. I don't know much. I am still learning. I am in a learning mode, and full of my life I done the embedded programming, and I did my master's in embedded system. So but I have little experience, and I am a developer by heart, and but still I am learning. So, and I am sharing my knowledge with you people. Feel free to comment, like, share with your friends. If you think they will be get advantage with this, share with them. Embedded is like a practice. If you just watching video, and like if you are not doing practice, probably it will have a very less advantage in your career. But if you literally want to make career in embedded system, I will say you start doing programming, and here is the complete channel for you with the source code. We are providing you the source code. Many projects we are going to provide that source code also. You can also make project using M5 board. If you are making any project, we will be happy to share all those information with our students. So you can write back to us. If you want to purchase the board, you can, mail ID is given. If you want to contact us, please feel free to contact on this mail ID. And have a nice day. Thanks for watching.